Now let's see about modes of data transfer. We can transfer data between I/O devices and memory using three approaches. The first approach is programmed I/O. The second approach is interrupt initiated I/O. Third approach is DMA. DMA stands for direct memory access. In this video, we are going to discuss about programmed I/O. So programmed I/O is mainly useful in order to transfer data between I/O devices and memory. So I/O devices means we can have either input devices or output devices. The most commonly used input device is keyboard. So if you consider keyboard, then the contents of the keyboard will be placed in memory with the help of the CPU. If you consider output device like monitor, then the contents of the memory will be displayed on the monitor with the help of the CPU. Programmed I/O, the name itself specifies the meaning. It is implemented with the help of a program. So here the point is very, very simple. Programmed I/O is mainly useful in order to transfer data between I/O devices and memory. Let us see this diagram first. Here we have CPU and I/O device. We know that there are several differences that exist between CPU and I/O devices. In order to resolve those differences, we use interface or I/O interface or I/O module. So between CPU and I/O device, we have input-output interface or I/O module, which resolve the differences between CPU and input-output device. Let's see the point here. Here I/O devices places some information on I/O bus, and after placing the information on the I/O bus, the corresponding I/O device enables data valid line. This data valid line specifies that some information is present in I/O bus. And after that, let us consider about interface. In interface, mainly two types of registers are used. The first register is data register and the second register is status register. In status register, we maintain flag bit. Here F stands for flag bit. The value of the flag bit may be either 1 or 0. Here the information which is present in I/O bus will be placed in data register. Once data register contains some information, then the flag bit value will be set to 1. So if the flag bit is 1, then it specifies that some information is present in data register. So whenever flag bit is set to 1, then the interface enables data accepted line. So data accepted line specifies that the corresponding information is present in the data register. It is just like an acknowledgement. I received the data. So that's why interface received the data. So that's why it is providing an acknowledgement to the I/O device with the help of the data accepted line. Now let's see the connections between CPU and interface. Here the information which is present in data register will be sent to the CPU with the help of the data bus. We know that totally there are three types of buses are present here: address bus, data bus and control lines. So this is nothing but data bus. So data bus is mainly useful in order to transfer the data from data register to the CPU. Next, CPU can access either input or output device by specifying its address. Every input or output device contains some address. So that address is specified with the help of the address bus. So the corresponding address of the input or output device will be placed in the address bus so that it accesses the corresponding devices with the help of this interface. Next, I/O read and I/O write are nothing but control lines. So mainly we can perform two operations here: read operation or write operation. So that we are specifying here. So in this way, data will be transferred between IO devices and CPU. So CPU means here that data will be transferred from IO devices to some memory with the help of the CPU. Now let's see the flowchart here. This flowchart demonstrates this program here. So a program is written in the computer. This is the flowchart for that program. Okay. First, this is in perspective of CPU. So CPU reads status register. Status register means it reads flag value. So it checks the flag bit. Suppose if flag bit is 1, then it specifies that data is present in data register. Let us assume that the flag bit is 1. So it specifies that data is present in the data register. So CPU reads data register and that data will be transferred to the memory. So transfer the data to the memory. And after that, it checks whether the operation is completed or not. Suppose if the operation is completed, very good, then it continues with execution of the remaining program. Suppose if the operation is not completed, then again it checks the status register. So whether the flag value is 1 or not. Okay. So likewise it will check here. Let's see the problem here. So first the CPU reads the status register. So that means it checks flag bit value. Let us assume that flag bit value is 0. So 0 specifies that data is not present in the data register. So if flag bit value is 0, then once again CPU will checks, will read the status register and checks the flag value. Suppose let us assume that flag value is one more time 0. So flag value 0 means data is not present in the data register. So once again CPU checks the status register. So likewise here the problem is, if the data is not present in the status register, if the data is not present in the data register, then the flag value is 0. So every time CPU has to check the status register whether it is 0 or not 1. Suppose if it is 0, so once again it will checks whether the status register value is 0 or 1. So here we are not utilizing the efficiency of the CPU in effective manner. Every time it is the responsibility of the CPU to check whether the status register is whether the status register flag is 0 or 1. Here IO interface doesn't send any signal to the CPU. It is the responsibility of the CPU to check whether that flag bit value is 0 or 1. So see, we know that CPU is extremely faster. In a millisecond, CPU can execute lakhs of instructions. But here what the CPU is doing, instead of executing those instructions, every time CPU checking the status register. Suppose if the status register flag value is 0, then CPU cannot execute the remaining instructions of the program. CPU cannot do the other activities in the program. CPU can stay in this loop only. CPU can be in this loop only. So CPU will be in busy waiting condition only. So every time CPU has to wait in this loop only in order to check the status register's flag value. So this is the problem here. Programmed IO is very very inefficient approach. Why? Because here it is the responsibility of CPU to check whether the flag bit value is 0 or 1. If the flag bit value is 0, then it stays in that loop only. Then the CPU will stay in this loop only. It cannot do the remaining activities of the computer. It cannot execute the remaining instructions in the computer. So this is the problem with programmed IO. We can overcome this problem with the second approach, that is interrupt initiated IO. So in the next video, we will discuss about interrupt initiated IO. Thank you.